Why it is so difficult to land a spacecraft on the moon? Let me tell you something amazing. Why it is so difficult? So we know about this solar system, all these 8 planets nicely going around the sun. That's what we learned about solar system, right? And the solar system stays in the Milky Way just like that, like other stars. That's what we learned, right? No. The kind of perception, the kind of understanding of the solar system is wrong that most of us hold. Because, let me tell you, Earth itself rotates at a speed of 1600 kilometers per hour. All of we now sit nicely in this room, but imagine what speeds we are going in. Earth itself is rotating at a speed of 1600 kilometers per hour. So we are all moving at that speed. And Earth goes around the sun at a speed of 1,08,000 kilometers per hour. And sun itself goes around the Milky Way galaxy at a speed of 8,28,000 kilometers per hour. And the entire Milky Way itself is moving through space at a speed of more than 20 lakh kilometers per hour. We are not steady here. We are not, yeah, we know that, yes, we think that we are not moving anywhere, but that's not the thing. Every object in the space moves. Every object. Nothing stays idle. Everything is moving in space. See, what we study in the books is a solar system with all these 8 planets and asteroids moving around the sun. And that's our solar system, not moving anywhere. That's wrong. Sun itself moves through space. You know how that movement looks like? That movement looks like this. That's the sun at the center. And all of the planets are moving around it, and the sun itself is moving through space around the Milky Way galaxy. Yes. So the orbits are not circular or elliptical. The orbits are, you know, you can see the path of the orbit. That's how they are. Right? It's like a helix. Our sun itself is moving through space, 8,28,000 kilometers per hour, and all these planets go around like this. So, as we were talking in the last 2 minutes, you are not at the same point in space as you were 2 minutes before. We already moved at least 20,000 kilometers. We're always moving. So every night in the bed, when you go to sleep and when you get up in the morning, unknowingly you travel at least 20 lakhs kilometers in the space. It's like a helix. The sun is moving, and around it all the planets orbit and asteroids. So you are not, you will not be, since you are born, you're not at the same place. Every second you move in the space as Earth itself is moving. Right? Now, moon is also moving around the Earth at a speed of 3,683 kilometers per hour. Now, Earth itself is rotating, moon is going, Earth is going around the sun. So how would you send a spacecraft, a rocket, when you launch to the moon and land there? So once, as Earth is rotating, the moon is at this place, when you launch a rocket, by the time after 5 minutes or so, moon is already gone somewhere. So if I ask you to, if I give you a stone and ask you to throw at a moving bird, flying bird, how difficult is it? Hard. How would you send a spacecraft to the moon that is 3,84,000 kilometers away from the Earth, moving around the Earth at a speed of 3,683 kilometers per hour? What kind of engineering you need? what kind of science you need, what kind of thinking, what kind of technology you need, which unveils the beauty of Chandrayaan 2. We're going to learn a lot about it now. This is going to be really fascinating. So launched on 22nd July, Chandrayaan 2 was